In this video, I'm going to show how you can make your character automatically run after he's moved for a certain amount of time. First thing we want to do is record in a number variable his original speed, and that's under movement properties, the on land speed. Let me show you where that number comes from. So if you edit the properties of an object, you go to movement properties. This ground speed, it's 5.5. That's the on land speed. Same thing. So we're going to record what that is when we start to level. And then when he starts to move, and so moving is in the movement events. When he starts moving, I'm going to set a counter variable, movement counter, equal to 0. And then the entire time that he is moving, this movement counter, we're going to increment it. I could increment it by 1, and so each frame this would increase. Brains run at 30 frames per second, so I'm going to divide that by 30, and then that way, instead of increasing each frame, it increases each second by 1 whole number. And then what I'll do is I'll say when that movement counter, which is now the number of seconds he's been moving, when it equals 4, then I'm going to change his movement speed. So movement properties, the on land speed is equal to his original speed times 2. And I'm just sort of arbitrarily picking 2, which is double his speed for running. Actually, I think it looks pretty good at that speed, but you can play around with the multiplier here to, you know, if you want him 1.5 or if you want him 10 times as fast, however you want to do it, you can play with that. And then what we'll do is when he's no longer moving, so when no longer moving, we're going to set his on-land speed back to its original value. So let's see what that looks like. So he's just moving for 4 seconds, and then he automatically starts running. And as soon as you stop, that 4 second timer is reset. So for many games, this we're done. This is, you know, after you've started moving for a bit, you can run fast. But I think it's more interesting when sprinting abilities are somewhat limited. So what we can do is we can change this and say after, say, 8 seconds, then we'll slow him back down. And then also we will reset that movement counter back to 0. So what this will do is he'll be able to run after 4 seconds. And for then the next 4 seconds, until we hit 8 seconds, he'll be at double speed. Then we'll slow him back down, and we'll reset that movement counter. But note that the movement counter is constantly changing while moving, so it'll eventually build itself back up to 4, and he'll run again. So we get sort of a cooldown where he can run. Here's his normal movement speed, and then he runs. And then after 4 seconds continually running, now he's slow again, but then 4 seconds after that, he can run again, and then I'll have a 4 second cooldown after this. So I think that looks pretty good. So to alter how soon he can run, so we could change this to, you know, 4 seconds is a long time. He can run after 2 seconds, and so the difference to here would be 8 seconds is when he can stop running, and 2 is when he starts. So he can run for 6, and then he'll pause for 2, and then run for 6. So by changing this 8 and this 2, you can change how soon he can run, and then how long he can run by changing the 8. So that's how to create automatic running. And then I expanded it to show how to limit the amount of limit the amount of time that he can run, and to build in a cooldown. If you don't want the cooldown to like if you want it where he has to stop, then what you would do is eliminate this line here. Don't reset the movement counter, and then the only way he'll be able to reset it is by starting to move again, which means that you had to stop first. So there's automatic running.